And we have been allowing it to be dark over us for a while because we have not taken time and prayed. We have not taken time and give God every square meter we want for ourselves. No, we're not going to be selfish now. We're going to give back God Belize this morning. Because we can't take care of it. Can you hear me this morning?
Yes.
I have one granddaughter. And I've been teaching her the fair admonition of God. As parents, we have failed when we have our children doing what they want, how they want, and want to be friends. My role as a mother is first and foremost to be a mother and a parent to my children, and I become their friends when they have understood at first I was their mother before I became their friend. I teach at the Baptist High School, and let me tell you something. Where the whole town, Mr. Leeper, is so radical for God, I will not compromise my position. I'm not into religion, I'm not into denomination, it's about a relationship with God. I'm not the essence of this whole thing this morning. Everybody got passion. Tomorrow, you think a coincidence is tomorrow, you know? Tomorrow, the judgment should come down. How much of us here are ready to dilute? Nobody, not for your cause, not for your passion. How much of us are ready to die tomorrow in the event the Chief Justice decides to take a life?
We ready? We ready?
Hold on. I've heard this foolish statement that some people are willing to stop being pastors than for murder game. And let me tell you something, I want to be a pastor, and I want to tell you, go away, I want rebuke the devil out of them, cast out the devil and lead them to Christ. That's the way you do. That's a great commission. Don't run away from the thing. Jesus Christ doesn't run away. If you run away, you don't die for us.
Start again.
God bless you. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, we are going to continue to move on. As we said, the I want. We must be able, right? If we will command respect,
exactly. Yes.
And if we will, we want to put the right thing in, we must do the right thing.
Yes, sir.
We cannot do the wrong thing and produce the right result. So,
the good one or the bad one?
Belmopan is known as the Garden City, right?
That is correct.
The city of promise.
So, all right.
So check this
Thank
out.
Thank you, baby.
Check this out. That's why blood has already been shed through Jesus.
Yep.
That's why.
That's
so we are going to continue walking because we got to go around that house exactly. representative yeah. and take it back to ourselves.
Exactly.
And it's great that we're stopping a little bit. We appreciate that. It's not a problem. Wow. But I would want us to give a distance
exactly.
in respect. Because we don't want to demolish structures, we want to reform them.
Woo!
We want to reshape them. We are not here to demolish.
Just move
because on. The state was supposed to protect us from Mason.
Yeah.
But the state got yeah. yes. in bed with Mason,
literally.
And so we literally became endangered. And so every structure of government is God anointed by yep. our constitution, but corrupted people have taken it over, and we say, I want my country. We move.
We want our country.
Speak up.
We got cartels involved in this.
We run right? by our gang,
so
our government.
Anything now, we're supposed to fight for this country. Yes. Because we're not sue cartels they do to Mexico.
Oh, yeah.
What you think they are do to little Belize?
Exactly.
Are you sure how they penetrated so easy? Yeah, one man penetrated so easy.
Yeah.
We can't tolerate that. But we want to recognize something too. For the time you mention that one cartel there, that means everybody where they head this right now, life in a danger. Straight up. But we waiting for put for we life. Right here, right now, any day for this country. Because me personally tired. I got four pick this to worry about. Four. I don't see a future with their people. None at all. I ain't hurtful. To be honest, you know.
You
hurtful.
Instead of pay the Belizean people.
We need to do something like call together. If we don't vote the UDP, we don't redeem ourselves.
We don't demand that. Go just like this. Watch out. We don't want to. They go just like this. Watch out. If Tempter say Belmopan, we don't take back this country, we know I take it back again. Because it's celebration are clothed with mine. The Roma are clothed with mine. The Expo are clothed with mine. The 21st are clothed with mine. And that's the way the politicians they want. Then they pray the 10th of September for. Just what before the 10th, when we call on them to come out, because Belize, I tell them, this right now is peaceful. Because we deal a lot of church people, and we respect that. But when they say Belize erupt, we want to go for near and far for fix it. Because listen to me, everything we won in Belize, won by two set of people, two set of family, two set of crony, two set of caretakers. So if Belize broke up, the only thing we could run a bit better Belize up on a fucking ruin. Sorry, because
let's go. My people, I just want to say, I want to share with you my experience with this ministry. I came back
from 2008. I'll leave her right up there.
All right, baby. So
I brought my resume to this place to try and get a job as a returning Belizean. And Mr. Lovell, the CEO, and I call out his name. And he can take me to court because I sat in his office with my resume, and this man looked at my face and told me, son, the position is politically compromised. This is when Carlos Perdomo was the minister. His son was away on study leave with pay, and I still volunteered. This country is overridden with these types of injustices. And this is what I was talking about when I said that if we want to stop the crime, we need to give the youth an opportunity. Can you imagine myself as a professional turning home and having no end? How can these young people feed? This is the very ministry that is in question at this very moment with the murder of Salu. To me, that murder represents every single Belizean that has fallen to gun violence or any type of violence. And the cover-up level that happens in this building, you would be surprised to know the amount of cover-up that is going on. My Belizeans, we need to start to demand, not asking for anything here. It is for us. It belongs to us. So we demand that what we rightfully supposed to get is not what we get. We need to demand right here an independent investigation.
Thank you very much. We have a woman that va hablar.
En español.
En español?
Yes.
Yes.
En español
y un poquito en inglés.
Un momentito.
We need to speak louder.
We must all learn to lead.
Yep.
We must all lead with a one country. Lead.
This is our country, and where are all the mothers? You know, so it's quite embarrassing to say that us, me, my husband, and I, as a church leader, we were expecting more of the churches out here, more of the pastors out here, and they're not here. And as Hispanics, I'm going to say in Spanish, hay muchos beliceños que son hispanos, que son de Centroamérica, han venido a Belice por una sola razón, por los crímenes que hay en los países ajenos, se han venido a Belice y Belice empieza a ser Guatemala y nadie se para. ¿Dónde estamos? ¿Dónde están las madres hispanas? ¿Dónde están los padres hispanos? Esto es todo Belice. Se esconde detrás de textos, se esconde detrás de llamadas a las estaciones como los TV y los demás. Que haya campaña, que haya esto, que haya lo otro, pero ¿dónde están? Entonces yo les agradezco a los que están aquí. I thank the ones that are brave enough to stand here. But this is Belize, and we're going from bad to worse. So let's join together, let's stand together for what is right. And that's what I want my children to learn from this age.
Ramon Cervantes Jr. They came last night, the family from Orange Wharf.
We have PG, we have Mango Creek here.
We have some villages. We got Dangriga here. We have Belmopan here. You sure we got Belmopan here?
Yes!
We got Kayo here. Belize City! And Corozal?
Chirrup.
All right. Ramon Cervantes Jr. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning. When
2 years ago my father was murdered, I said, I don't wish this on anyone.
Yeah.
And I never expected that this would happen again in our country.
Yeah.
And why I say this is because, in addition to all the senseless murders that are going on in this country, the murder of my father and the murder of Pastor Lou are similar in many circumstances, in many ways. Where all the facts, all the events that unfold point to the criminals having deep connections with those high-level ministers. And then they bring in the department, the police department, to mop up their mess. And now even the prime minister is trying his best to cover up the mess. But it can't be covered anymore. There's a saying,
it's nowhere.
You cannot cover the sun with one finger.
Exactly.
And I am glad that we are here today. Last night at the vigil, I didn't know Pastor Lou, but I sympathize with his family.
Yes.
In the most profound way, our family sympathizes with his family because it's hurtful.
Yes, man.
And we have to stop it now, because if this continues, the question is, who's next?
Exactly, man.
Who is next?
You pick me next.
That's the question we need to ask.
Every single one.
In my father's case, there was alleged involvement of a high-level minister and a high-level police official. The high-level minister retained his post, and the high-level police official was promoted to here to Belmopan as Assistant Commissioner of Police and Head of CIB. In this case, Mr. Mason had connections to everybody, all the important ministers. One by one, you see them on television. The only one that hasn't shown his face is the Minister of Agriculture. But if you follow what was happening to import $300,000 worth of corn, you need a license, a special license from the Ministry of Agriculture.
Yes.
So why is it that only Mason was the only one that could facilitate such license to import so much corn when we produce corn in this country?
Yes.
It's a web of corruption. And our ministers have a lot of bloods in their hands.
Yes, man.
Yes, man.
A lot of bloods. And we have to demand justice. And we have to get justice
before
we hurt more families.
Exactly.
Because the whole country right now is hurting.
Exactly, brother. Yeah. I feel up.
Let
man.
Not
right
this one with
brother.
Pastor Lou pass away like that, please. We, as a family, we have not let my father's one pass away.
Yeah,
let this one with Pastor Lou not pass away. And
not.
I think we should revive the one with the four Judge Street guys, the guys
exactly,
that were killed by Blue Street and Judge Street, I believe, where their throats were taken out at the end of the night. And then they tried to tell us that it could be the Zetas and... No, it's our cartels right here in Belize, and they're headed by the highest ministers. And we have to stop it now. And so, ladies and gentlemen, let's take the message out. A lot of people are afraid to come out because of these same things that are happening.
Political
victimization. People are afraid of being victimized or being fired from their jobs because these people's tentacles are very deep inside. As deep as Mason's tentacles were in this government, from minister to minister. You know, the government has their tentacles deep into businesses that they have. They have intimidated. So we need to take the message to our people. This is a start. When my father died, I said, I hope good things come out from this. This is the beginning of the cleansing of our country.
Yes.
Last night, one of the pastors said the same thing.
that we hope good things come out from Pastor Moon's murder. Let's not give up these opportunities. Let's have faith in God and carry on. Be strong. Let's be strong and fix our country. We need to fix our country because this is our country. We have nowhere else to run. I don't have a green card.
Exactly.
I can go somewhere, but I want to live here.
Exactly.
I want to live in my country.
We love to be blessed.
I want to live in my country.
We love to be blessed.
That's the way I want to live. I want my generations to live in a peaceful country.
Yes, exactly.
Where we respect each other.
Exactly.
Regardless of our differences.
Give the kids everything.
Regardless of differences, we have to let each other live. And so, my people, I ask you, let this murder of Pastor Lou, just like my father's, be like the seed. A seed has to die before it can flourish into the biggest tree and give the sweetest of fruits. Let's not waste this opportunity. Let's have faith in God and continue the fight to clean our country and to get rid of those corrupt ones that are up there and bring them down and let peace and justice reign in our country. Thank you very much.
I'll tell you a funny thing. A lot of people, hundreds of people, tell me, be careful, Louis.
I may think their head are cut off first, Louis, to God.
They say, be careful, they say, be careful.
I know, slow and worry about you.
They say, watch your back. High ranking police, say, Louis, watch your back.
Exactly.
Be careful. And I am careful. But you know, everybody who say, be careful, or think that I need to be careful, that means you don't know what kind of country you
are. Exactly.
You don't know.
Exactly.
Under whose protection you are.
Yeah. And if this is the state of the country now, when are we just nice? We nice? What will it be for your children?
Yes.
What will it be for your children?
Pastor, I like you on the top.
Mason trained people already.
Mm-hmm.
Mason trained people. Those people who did those gruesome murder. They had Belizeans watching how it is done. And people like Mason were doing it for millions of dollars, hundreds of thousands of dollars. But you see, now that Mason is in jail, those guys, how will they make their money now? How will those Belizeans make their money now?
Hitmen.
They will not go, they can't go after the million-dollar guys because they can't take pictures like Mason with the big guys. So they don't have access to the big guys. So those people who are trained by those guys will go after the middle and lower people. And they will want to extort us, not for a million or half a million. They will want to do it for $1,500, $2,000. So we are all in trouble.
We know in the court.
Because he has trained people and other people have trained people. And the people who are supposed to have our back. You see how much police officers they have out here right now?
And then they hire more.
They had more police officers guarding Mason than we're out here right now.
They don't give a crap about none of we.
None
of we. They don't care.
The tips. TIPS. Trafficking in persons report.
Yeah.
Come out every year from states. And America having them in a black and white. That the police officers, they guard the places where there is human trafficking.
Why?
They have it right there. Some of the officers in a uniform.
Mm-hmm.
Because some of the same ministers help traffic and they frequent those places.
All of we talk
about slavery. We hate slavery, slavery past. White man this, white man slavery that. Belize, that the worst place in a Central America and Latin America for the slavery of people. Right here. It's in the report. It is a fact. Belize, Guatemala, that tier two. Mexico, that tier two. All the other places, as bad as they are tier two, Belize are the only country in this region with a tier three. And the marking police officers. I will wind up with this because we're going over yonder back. And I'll tell you this, Deputy Commissioner of Police, Acting Commissioner now, stood up in front of the nation
and told us that it was an attempted kidnapping. I don't think about it because he has never recanted. He said attempted. So what happened? I want you to listen because he know everything, the most important thing about the case. And I want you to think about this. When the Mennonite realized that the 300,000 was gone, and you need to understand how de-risking played a role. Because the honest businessmen who do a lot of deal, they work with the deal through the bank. But as de-risking is coming down because of the same corruption, the honest business people are finding it difficult to find U.S. currency.
Yes. Oh, yes.
So people like Mason come out of the woodwork because they will now offer the currency. You see, so de-risking is a weird thing because everybody they holler de-risking because it make the country look bad, but the corrupt people, they will benefit from de-risking because now honest people will take their money to them and they can now wash their laundered money with clean businessmen. You need to understand.
Exactly, I know you're talking.
You see, so what happened now when the Mennonite realized that he gets scammed, he come to Mason with his wife for money or can. And Mason, you tell me if this is a kidnapping. He put a gun to his head. Kara to the house. Kara in the basement.
Yeah, wife.
He and his wife. Now imagine your wife with you. Imagine your husband with you. Imagine what they got through your mind.
Yes.
Duct tape them. Put them down there. Then get in our vehicle with them and carry them way down by Sibun. The kidnapping yet or not kidnapping?
How much? 2 pounds are kidnapping.
How much people are there?
2 pounds.
Is it attempted kidnapping?
2 pounds.
I am imagining that happening to me. Happening to me, and I got at the station and the police look at it and said I just attempted kidnapping. But you know done there? Because he promised to pay a ransom. Is that kidnapping?
Yeah.
They let him go, he got in a Spanish, they got talk to the community leaders. And they pay ransom. They paid it right in front of between BME and Wali Bar. Right there the deal occurred. And it was the officials from the Mennonite community who were watching. Because the way how Mennonites work, they know how to make that man go out to go deliver money by himself. That the whole community. So this thing was not done in the dark. So not only was a ransom requested, but a ransom was paid.
Deal or no
so
deal, no?
Is that attempted kidnapping or is it kidnapping?
Kidnapping.
No. You're not done. Because he's there. And he's talking that the report may mix up. But let's put aside that kidnapping apart. When Mason took Llewellyn, weren't there two pastors there?
And it could have been me too.
And he
could have been me too.
Could have been in it.
That is one of them. I could have been in it. I escaped it by seconds.
That is correct.
Yes. He, Pastor Lou, called me 6:30 in the morning. And he said, I want you to come here right now. I said, what's going on? So we need to go live. Right? And I tell the pastor, I can't do it. I have a group that me host, and I have a group that come out the camp. So I'm in the middle of two groups. And he said, I just need 10 minutes of your time. That's all I need, 10 minutes of your time. So I tell the leader, I'll be back in 10 minutes. So we went there. Pastor Lou didn't make any arrangement with Pastor Wade, you know, to come live. So we couldn't went live. So I tell them, well, we couldn't go live. Make I gather on our hand and we pray outside. We pray outside the station. So if I never have them two groups, I could have been a victim like them too. I could have been a victim of being kidnapped too. But see, and you know, I could have been beheaded too. I don't know what could have happened. I can't imagine the trauma that I would have gone through and my family would have gone through. But this is us. We are Belize and we are a nation and we need to stand against crime.
That's right.
Okay? So, thank you.
Thank you. You see how simple and easy one decision that you make. One decision. Because these people are already in the country. And those two pastors stay at the bottom And when they realized that Lou was not coming out back, they went in. And yeah. Gun was put to their head. Yeah. They were tied up. So you know what? Even if it was attempted kidnapping that he wanted to call the two things with the Mennonite, that man stood there and told us attempted kidnapping. Meanwhile, he knew that Mason had also kidnapped two pastors along with that man.
Yes.
So there are four
people.
Four plus. But there were husband and wife, two pastors. What?
Was there not a kidnapping that was withdrawn because...
I don't know about that.
What were they doing at
the husband and wife were kidnapped. That's not threatened. And they made a 12-page official report. The same one that all of them are saying is not possible. But what I am telling you is this, that the man stood there and called it attempted kidnapping, knowing in his head that there were two pastors kidnapped on one occasion and a husband and wife on another occasion. How can we trust the results coming from the mouth of these people when four people kidnap separate events and they will just call it
attempted
kidnapping? Somebody else has them and we want them back. We need the position of commissioner, the position of attempted commissioner, and all of the positions, we need them.
Yes.
To be working for behalf of the people. We need to move on. All we spent a little bit too much time here.
True.
We go one.
And be like the other nations around, but people who want to see this nation stand as a light to the other nations. We thank you for Belize, we thank you that you have your hand on Belize, and we thank you that nothing happened by accident. Llewellyn's murder was wicked, cruel, but it is now going to be the means from which we go forward, that heads will roll, that need to roll, not necessarily cutting off heads, but bringing things to the fore that have been hidden.
Yes.
Because your word says there is nothing hidden that shall not be revealed.
Yes.
And we pray for the revelation of this crime situation, that we will come to the bottom of it, not just finding the knife in the pond, but finding the why this happened. Why did this man go so far for so long? We ask for divine intervention because we cannot look to help from man. Our help coming from the Lord. We thank you for those who have come. Be a hedge of protection around us. Be a means of speaking to the Prime Minister and all the members of Parliament and all those who do not want to come into the light. Bring them into the light. Expose the darkness. Your word says, in him was light, and the light was the life of men. The light shineth in the darkness, and the darkness could not overpower it. Darkness will not overcome Belize in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. God bless you. Thank you very much.